You know, when you start a project and you have to go clean an area to start the project, I don't like doing that. I want to have a clean area so when I walk in here, I can just start the project without having to do a bunch of cleanup and searching for tools and all that stuff. So get sick of that, right? Well, what I'm taking apart right here is what was left of our old swing set. And I put this up probably, 8, 9 years ago, something like that, when the girls were little. I was thinking about turning it into a buck pole, you know, just take off the slide and the swings. And I'll tell you what, these times, they go so fast. You don't realize it when you're in the middle of it, but man, do these times fly. It's just like yesterday we were putting this thing together. And now here I am taking it all apart, taking out all the legs and turning it back into just regular lumber. I don't know what I'm gonna use it on yet, but maybe a chicken coop or something. I'll show you what I'm doing right now. I'm using this skinny thin punch. Works perfect to knock those lag bolts out. But I'll show you what I'm doing. That one's a little rough, but we'll see. Never know what you get into out here. All right, got to put these in storage somewhere and think of the next project to use these on, but time goes fast, you guys. These are memories from my kids were little. Now they don't even live here anymore. And there it is, the last nail. Think I should save these, straighten them out, or just get rid of them? What's it worth if you can't get anything more, if you can't replace these new? Don't know. Think about it. Well, I can straighten these out. It won't take long to do it. See, some of these are pretty rough. You guys, check these out. Yeah, these ones are pretty rough. All these are galvanized, though. But, let's see, I've got a bent one there, and then these four are pretty rough. In the middle, I mean, the ends are probably good. I can, you know, they might be a little boogered up here from hitting them at the end, but I can clean those threads up, use them. I mean, here's the brackets. Still have these good brackets. They were part of that swing set kit. But as far as these little nails go, those are old school nails. They're my grandpa's nails. If you have something like this, steel block, you can flatten out nails if you have to. I don't mind it. It doesn't take long. It's not too bad. Check it out. This glove is just in the way. All right, see, it's not too bad. and kind of, look at that. That can be reused. Let's do this one. Look at that. That one's crazy. I just put the head there and kind of roll it a little bit. That's all it takes. Look, it's not that bad. I'll just toss them back into the bin. Oh, this one's got a double bend in it. Look, right there and there. Let's see if I can bring this to the end here. And that straightened. Not bad. You can hear the different sound when it's bent. Look at that. Not bad at all. 2022 is a strange year, you guys. Seen a lot of weird things. 7 nails ready to use again. Now let's see what I can do with this. This thing's in rough shape. If I can get it close to straight without it breaking, it might work. Let's do this one this way. Hey, it's close. Look at it. Not bad. The most important part is the end threads. So I can just clean those up and reuse them again. So look, everything here is reusable. Repurposable. And I'll just put all this stuff back in the bin. I'll probably hit, what do I have here? I've got some... this spray, let me show you guys something. All right, so this right here is my favorite stuff. This is the AMSOIL Metal Protector, the MP version. And this stuff is great because it says lubricate, freeze rusty parts, protects against corrosion and displaces moisture. So what I do is I'll take a pan, if I have old parts like those bolts and those nails, even bike parts or mower parts or whatever it is, I'll just get a pan. Here, I got one right here.
This is metal.
So like these little parts right here, see this? These are parts from one of the bikes, one of the Schwinn bikes. And I just, come on, get in there. And I'll just spray in there every now and then. Just lubricate everything. And some of the stuff, like I have, this is what I want to show you right here, my metal tray. I couldn't find it, but I see it down below here. So, I'll take these old metal trays, right? Check this out. See this little metal tray? And I have some old diesel oil. Well, not old. It's just left over in some of the bottom of those pans. And I have a chain in here from one of the old Schwinn bikes. A set of pliers, needle nose, that are starting to work again. And this old clamp, this old American-made clamp. Check this bad boy out. Look at that. So, I am going to let that stuff sit in there, soak. It kind of cleans it up, lubricates it. And then I'll do the same thing with those bolts and those nails. And then toss them to the bin where they go after they dry off. So, I don't know. I just like to save stuff. I can't stand throwing everything away like that, but I can see these being reused again. But definitely I need to go around this shop and outside in the barn or in the yard and start going through stuff. I've got too much stuff. And that's going to bring us to another video of having too many tools. I have too many tools right now, you guys. I've gotten so many tools given to me or that were left over on a job site, whatever it was, but they're not my good tools. I mean, my good tools are right here in my craftsman boxes, right? In my good boxes. But the tools that I'm talking about that I have to get rid of, there's a whole bunch of them, and they are the Chinese tools. You know, the cheap stuff that I don't have anything to do with. I don't need them. They're just and I don't want to throw them away. I want to give them to somebody. So some young guy that's just starting out, that needs tools, doesn't have a budget for it. I have plenty of tools back there that I don't use because all my main tools are here or in my truck. So if you guys know of anybody who has, you know, needs tools that doesn't have any right now, I mean, I have a whole mess of Chinese stuff, you know, wrenches, box end opening. I have ratchets, sockets, screwdrivers, hammers. What else is back there? Holders, tool holders. Those kind of, I have a couple bags and stuff, but just multiple stuff. I just don't want to throw them away, and I'd like to give them to somebody who can. Look at my camera dropping. I'd like to give them to somebody who can, you know, use these things without just use them. I want to give them to somebody who can use them. A young guy, a young buck, you know, somebody who's just starting out. So if you guys know somebody like that and they're local to Michigan here, I'd like to put together a nice little tool case, toolbox, whatever it is, and hand it to them, because somebody helped me, you know what I mean, the same way. And ever since I started buying tools, collecting tools, I slowly take out the stuff that, you know, the Chinese ones. I just get rid of those tools because I don't need them. I have my Craftsman and Snap-on and, you know, Williams tools and stuff now. So, all American made tools. That's what I keep. But hey, you might know somebody. If you do, you might have a son or a cousin or a daughter's boyfriend, whatever it is, let me know. And if I can help out, I'll get them, hook them up with some tools. So, I think that's it. I'm going to go get these parts soaking in the oil. And I'm going to go look around out in the yard, because I know there's a ton of stuff I got to get rid of. I've got a pile of stuff I'm going to take it to the end of the driveway, get rid of, because I'm not going to use it anymore. I need to purge out a lot of stuff. I'm just too much stuff. Too much stuff. That's it. So maybe I'll show you some of that stuff here coming up. Maybe we'll talk, take a walk around the yard a little bit, and I will show you what I'm talking about, because there's just a lot of stuff that I just don't want it anymore. There's an old deer decoy that I have out there, you know, a full body one. It's been shot so many times, but maybe I should just get rid of it. If I take it to the end of the driveway, a lot of people, they just pick stuff up that I put down there. Like, I even put an old hot tub down there, and they took it. Purge out all the stuff I don't need, organize, like this back wall. Remember when I did that back wall? So this has been great now for, what, 3-4 years, this back wall. I enjoy the heck out of it. It's easy. None of it's in a toolbox. I'm using the shop here as the toolbox, right? So this wall is a display wall for all the tools that I use the most are over here. And then next to me here is the toolboxes where everything's laid out now. I've gone through all this stuff. It's clean, easy to go through and find things that I need. So I just need to do that to the rest of the shop, organize it, get rid of stuff. I'd like to donate a lot more stuff here, just to open up more room, because I have a lot of floor space here that, you know, there's the old a mower there, still good. I'm not getting rid of that. That's for mowing around here. Jet ski, golf cart, old sink from the house that, I don't know, it might be a sink that I build, or I build a bathroom down here and put that sink in it. I'm not sure yet, so gotta figure that stuff out. Plus the bikes, you know, I'm getting into the Schwinn bikes, the American-made Schwinn bikes, you know, the 82s and older. So I have a little setup for that right here too. So that's just what I've been up to lately. I need to make a few more videos. I'd like to just make more videos of me just doing stuff down here, because you guys seem to like it. I enjoy it, and it's good, clean fun. So take a walk around, and I'll show you what I'm talking about as far as out there in the yard, whether the stuff that I want to get rid of or clean and donate or give away, whatever it is. But let's go take a walk around, because now the summer's to an end, we're in the fall, and a lot of the stuff is dying off out there, so we can kind of see more of what I have. All right, so let's go out there and take
a walk. It's windy out here. All right, but anyway, I've been piling this stuff up. Come on. You see that old wheelbarrow right there? I got the wheelbarrow. This box right here is one of those boxes that you see on the patio. It's a cooler, basically. It was given to me a long time ago, and it's cool and everything, but we just don't use it anymore. There's that full body deer mount or deer target, and then the box behind it. It's still a good box. It still works, but we have another box, and what we've been using this box here for is just for storage. And I don't need that anymore because we have different ones, but it's good for outdoor storage of cushions and all these kind of things. And the lid, you know, it just flops up, and we just tape those sides. And but we're not going to use it again this winter, so I'm going to put that down the end of the road. Anyway, there's the jet ski trailer. We're going to keep that. There's a water tank right there. We're going to keep that. Plastic pallets. You can never get rid of those. I use plastic pallets. There's my hanger right there for the bag. Boulders. Oh, this right here, you guys, is it heats up water. It uses solar to heat water up for the swimming pool. It's been sitting there for a long time. We have a furnace that we use now, so I don't have to do that, but I'm gonna roll that up and maybe give it to somebody. It still works. There's the good, hang on, get this going. Focus. That's the good pig cooker, big barbecuer. A couple of tanks, fuel tanks, got those two 500 gallon tanks. And then see right here, I've been putting all my materials on, like this one here with all these blocks. That one is on a plastic pallet, so I can move that around the yard. And then mow, because that's what I want to do, is be able to pick this stuff up during the year, throughout the year, and just mow. Because, you know, right now, all summer, that's been growing like crazy, all around the forks. Those two steel pallets back there, one has brick pavers in it, the other one has limestone in it. So those are good. I can just pick those up with the Bobcat and move them around. That's easy enough. And then right here, this is all going to be firewood. This tree right here is a combination of some cherry and oak that was taken down. And then this bigger pile, that's a bunch of oak from a tree that the county took down just down the road. And I went down there and grabbed most of it with the Bobcat. In the back behind it, you see that bin back there? Those blocks. Well, there's another one right there with an old makeshift kind of roof on. The roof is gone now, so I'm going to take that down. Come on, focus. That's usually where I put all my bins, bin storage for firewood. It's like this here. See, with the wagon, I need to weld up the front. The little hitch came off and I was trying to drag this back, so I gotta weld that back on so I can use it. This is what I use for the as a wagon on the golf cart. Pile of wood here, that's 3 years old. That stuff back there is probably more like 5-6 years old, but it's still good. I use that in the barn to keep that warm. But yeah, this structure around here, I'm taking that down. Right now we get a bunch of turkeys that come up there and they hang out, about 15-20 turkeys they get up there. But I want to, this is my wood, firewood process area. So from this bin to that barrel right there, all the way up to the fuel. I'm going to organize that, get all that moved, get all that wood chopped up right there, and just mow this lawn. Now over here, we have cinder blocks. This table fell apart. There was an old pallet, kind of broke apart, but that's what I was selling firewood from, the table. And you see my metal box back there, the red one. Yeah, that kind of tipped over. So I got to clean all that up and fix it, make a better stand. Everything over here, as far as organization goes, this is not bad. I just haven't moved it, and I haven't been able to mow this. So that's what I want to do. So there's a bunch of there's two plastic pallets up there and some good wooden ones, which I don't think I'm going to use those wooden ones because it just does not last. So that's plastic. That one is, I think, wood, but I'm going to put that one on one of those plastic ones. Scrap, steel scrap, that's going away. Tires, rims for trailers, I'll go through those. I'll get rid of some of that. I have some fence cyclone fence, gates, and some fence on a pallet back there. Go through that, get everything transferred to plastic. That way I can move them around the yard, mow, put them back. Here's a 1 yard bucket for the bobcat, nothing wrong with that. There's some miscellaneous steel down in here underneath that grill, that grate back there. There's some racking. Go through that. There's some old plumbing or pond stuff back there. Pipes and underground irrigation stuff back there. Another fuel tank right there, that blue one, used for burning. And then over here, this is the overgrown garden area. And all this right here, oh, this camera is just way too close. I need a different lens. This is all burned. This is a couple trees that I took down, and I just gotta burn all that. So I'll do that this winter. And wow, it's getting really windy up here, you guys. Start walking back. Over there's where I grow the pumpkins. That pile right there, that's old leaves from last year, and I just roll it around. That's probably 8 feet tall. I roll that around every year, and then I'll mix these leaves in with those, and I make a brand new hump for next year. It's great compost. It turns into the best soil for planting gardens, planting vegetables, whatever you're going to use. That's the best stuff. I just mix it all up every year a couple times. That's a big apple tree right there. And what else? Oh, there's the dump trailer right there. Beehive back there. This trailer bought brand new years ago, back in 99. Not sure what I'm gonna do with that one yet. It's a good enclosed one. It's a little beat up, just needs to be cleaned. It's not too bad, other than that dent you see in the front. Somebody, one of the guys did that. These are just all pallets. And a little bit of roofing, that could be for the chicken coop. A new chicken coop or a wood, you know, covered, you know, for firewood to put the roof, you know what I mean? So I can use that. There's enough there to make a nice little shed for a wood shed. And then that blue tarp back there, that's a fishing, ice fishing sled. Everything else, that's just all pallets. So I get those pulled away and I can mow all that and get rid of all that. And that's just raspberries or mulberries or some kind of berries. Right here, this is all steel scrap. It's going back to the shop or to the recycler. All right, it's windy out here. Let's get back in here. And here's what's left of the pumpkins this year. Be eating those seeds up soon. So, all right.
Yeah, so that was just like a little recap, and basically that's just what I want to do. I want to get this stuff cleaned up, get everything taken care of. I also want to say thanks for helping me get over 1,000 now. So I'm over 1,000 subs here on the channel, and that helps big time because now it opens up more opportunities for me to do stuff. I can do live things. I can take super chats now. I can, I forgot what else. Like, there's monetary stuff now. That's all opened up. So. And you know what's funny is now that I broke that 1,000 subscriber mark, it seems like all of a sudden my videos are getting more views. So I don't know what's going on there. I suspect shenanigans, right? As we can from the tube. The views, you know, this is without me making any new videos or anything. The views are up. The subscriber count just keeps going faster and faster. So I didn't change anything other than I broke that 1,000 subscriber threshold. So some algorithms must have changed or kicked in or whatever, because all of a sudden now my videos are being seen, and I haven't made a new video in a long time. Not until last summer, winter. So of course there's shenanigans. We know that with YouTube. So don't know what to tell you. I'm just going to try to do stuff here. I do have a podcast that I can't put here on this channel. There's no way, because it would get blown out in two minutes. So I'm not going to try to even you know, a lot of people said, well, are you going to, you know, go live here with your YouTube or with your podcast? I was like, no, I can't. Because it'd just blow the channel up. That what we say on that podcast, it won't fly on YouTube. There's no free speech here, right? So if you guys want to see that or listen to the podcast, you can go do that. It's a weekly show. At the top of my page here, if you look like in, you know, the main banner where it says the, you know, my cover where it says Jesse James up top, in the lower right corner of that, you'll see it says the podcast there. Click on that. And that'll take you over to a link to where the podcast is at. Again, like I said, I'm not going to mix the podcast with this here. It's different content. Plus, that content will not make it here on this YouTube stuff. So they just, you know, I considered doing it, but why blow up this channel if I don't have to? If I can just show you guys what I like to do outside here in the shop, out there with hunting and all that stuff and working on equipment, I'd rather just keep this avenue for that. And if you guys want to cross over, whatever, and I can bring my podcast people over here so they can see what I like to do when I'm not podcasting. So, I don't know. It's just a mix of everything. So, just again, thanks for helping me get over 1,000 subs. And like I said, it opened up a lot more stuff. So I'll just do more stuff inside here. And like I said, I'll be able to go live now out here in the shop if I'm working on one of the old bikes, like this old Schwinn bike frame, like this thing right here. This was my grandpa's. This was actually two of my grandpa's. This thing is a 1955 Western Flyer. This is American made. It's not the Schwinn, obviously. All the Schwinns are in, down there in the storage, but you know, like my Stingrays and the, what else do I have? The Breeze. Oh, there's a couple more I forgot. But those, you know, if I'm working on stuff like that down here, you guys help me along and do fun little projects like that, right? So that's what this channel is going to be for. It's just for working down here, working on stuff, you know, just doing what I do around the homestead here. The chickens, anything that I grow, anything that I build, the fishing, the hunting stuff, we can do all that here. And I'll keep that to this channel. While the podcast is something totally different that will get you thinking. All right, so I guess that's it for now. So listen, stay dangerous, everybody. All right, Jesse James, you know, I thank you for watching the Jesse James channel here. And if you want to check that podcast out, like I told you, click that little spot up there in the cover art where it says the podcast. So that's it, you guys. We'll talk to you soon. And I'm looking forward to having fun with you here, doing more stuff on this channel. So we'll see you guys. Bye-bye. So Ink is big. Look at her. And the other one is over there. She's big too. They're bathing. And then this one is just a small one. She has new feathers coming up. New growth on her head and on her back. So that's her.